Hello, it's Sunday, July 20th, and I'm Tony Christopher, financial analyst at UFX Markets Trading Support Center. This is your week in review. Today, we will discuss some of the major financial events of the past week and how they impacted the currency and commodity markets. In currency news, the euro traded lower against the US dollar on Friday as it fell below the critical level, $1.35, for the first time since February on a strong dollar. The greenback rose in the wake of the Malaysian plane crash in Ukraine, which killed 298 passengers, and Israel starting a ground operation in Gaza. The euro fell to 1.3492 on Friday, but recovered later that day and remained above the level of 1.35. The euro was last trading against the US dollar at the level of 1.3524, which is a decrease of 0.01%. The Japanese yen hit a five-year high against the euro amid fears that tensions between Russia and the West will escalate after the Malaysian airplane crash, which may lead to further sanctions on Russia. However, the Japanese currency lost gains at the beginning of the European trading session on Friday, falling by 0.2% against both the US dollar and the euro. The Japanese yen traded lower against 27 out of 30 currencies. The Japanese yen was last trading against the US dollar at the level of 101.34, which is an increase of 0.16%. In commodities news, WTI crude oil completed its first weekly gain in a month, gaining 3.2% since July 15th. The geopolitical issues sent the prices higher, peaking at 103.94 per barrel. WTI crude oil was last trading at the level of 103.13, which is a decrease of 0.6%. Oil was last trading at 107.24, which is a decrease of 0.65%. Gold has spiked after 4 weeks of decline, possibly as a reaction to the turmoil in the Middle East and the escalating tensions between Russia and Ukraine. Investors see the commodity as a safe haven, resulting in its increased demand. Nonetheless, gold is still down due to concerns over the possible raising of the interest rate by the Fed. Gold was last trading at 1310.88, which is a decrease of 0.63%. And that's our summary of the financial headlines from the past week. We hope that you've enjoyed this week's review and that you'll tune in tomorrow morning as we kick off the new trading week with the latest top market news. Until then, be sure to log into ufxmarkets.com for all of your trading needs. Your personal account manager is ready to answer all of your questions. UFX Markets Trading Support Center wishes you a successful trading week.